is Capener.
All right, we're getting ready now for the second half. It should be a great second half. We'll be back with the second half of today's game. There's your score, 43-35. UTEP in front. We'll be back. Your guess is as good as mine. I wouldn't want to predict the outcome of this ball game because they've been really digging at each other all that first half.
Well, you expect BYU to certainly get back in this thing. They're playing at home in front of their home crowd, and not for a minute would you be able to think that UTEP is in control of this basketball game, although they're ahead by eight.
This young man's going to have to score, and he did not on that one. Chapman, finger roll, 4-2. Good shot.
Capener didn't get it to go down, but what he did, he created and allowed Chapman to sneak underneath for the rebound. I expect Bobby Capener to come out and shoot the basketball a lot in the second half.
Sandle from the corner answers the challenge with that net ripper.
You know, Gary Golson said last week, if UTEP shoots the basketball good from the outside, they're almost impossible to beat because they're so good athletically. So far today, they have shot the basketball very, very well from the outside.
Brian Tate, a great pass to Smith. Soft one-hander for two. Three baskets in a very short period of time.
And a good start for BYU. Into the rhythm of the offense. Not standing
around. Hardaway's on him defensively. They swing it inside to Smith. He has to shoot, and he does. 46-41. UTEP in front by five.
You can notice the tempo of this game has picked up. BYU defensively really picking up the pace.
Richmond for two more. They got a man loose underneath baseline. There's the move. There's the shot. It's good. He's fouled. Basket counts.
The entire game, Haskins now is up. He wants a timeout.
Haskins is hot. Right now, there's a shot of the Bear, and the Bear's having to say. All right. 17:07 remaining in the ballgame. Scoreboard reads this break and play. UTEP 48, the BYU Cougars 46. We'll be right back at the Marriott Center right after we take timeout for this. Cougars control. From the corner, ooh. Smith's shot is blocked, but he gets it back. He'll try it again, and he gets it for two.
And he's the guy they look for to get him going, and certainly here in the second half, Michael Smith's been everywhere. He shot the basketball. He's doing everything, and BYU's got
BYU by two, 13:44 to go in the game. Don't go away. Send somebody else to the refrigerator. Defense.
Excellent defense. Bobby Capener calling him over there. Stevenson. Capener wants to shoot the ball if he can.
Jumper by Stevenson. Not good. Knighting with a rebound. It goes sky high. And then the ball is knocked out of bounds off the white uniform. Alert play by the UTEP
player. The ball game. Michael Smith, their best player. He has four fouls. We'll see how it works out.
Now if you're UTEP, you want to go with the big guy. They dish it outside, little jumper, soft and good. Nice shot. Creative and good as Brian Taylor hits a couple of free throws, and that may be a big factor in this game as we go down to the wire. Free throw shooting. BYU has an edge in that category. Little bouncer low, baseline right side, blocker shot, good. Athletic ability on that shot from the corner. He has 8 points in a game. Tied again, Twin 56ers. A steal. Jeep Jackson, they'll never catch him, as one guy likes to say, and they do not.
Not much to say about that. You saw it. Jeep Jackson's quick hands. And again, BYU really playing without a true point guard. Bobby Capener is an off guard. So is Brian Taylor. And I think you'll probably see the youngster come in for BYU, Marty Haas, shortly because they have problems handling the basketball without him.
Three-point shot by Capener doesn't go, and the rebound is hustled out of there by Blocker. 58-56, UTEP by two. Richmond, he scores. Has 17 in the game. And all of a sudden, it's a four-point lead for UTEP. Swings the other way. Chapman back in the ballgame, playing with four personal fouls. Little bouncer in the lane, Smith. Oh, look out, he missed a good one there. The rebound, Chapman scores. Marty Hawes back in the lineup. Add some quickness and agility and speed and tenacity to this BYU team. We're tied at 60-60. In the lane, there's a little fallaway one-hander for 2 points for Jerry Jones, a freshman from Country Club Hills in Illinois.
of BYU right now. They've got to do a better job defensively denying the entry pass. UTEP's getting the ball inside.
Yeah.
Anytime they want it.
Has 18 points. Gates is back in the ball game right now. He's a good ball handler. He's been hurt a little bit this year. One of the reasons why he hasn't played maybe as many minutes as a year ago. Jumper by Hardaway is good.
Well, Adell Anderson just put his hands on top of his head. They played great defense that time. They got Hardaway to take a 15-footer that he had to double clutch, and it went down.
64-62, 7:28 remaining in this ball game.
We've got Quinton Gates now matched up on Mike Smith.
Good pass to Taylor, but he missed the shot too far under that time. And the rebound hustled out of there by Richmond. Long lead pass to Jeep Jackson. Too hard off the glass. Rebound. Gates back on the rim for two.
Well, there they are. Up-tempo basketball game. Getting an easy shot. They miss it. Right there to
Smith. Look out. Leans in. Got it going.
Now he's on fire. You got to get him the basketball every time down. He doesn't have to shoot it every time, but he's got to touch it every time.
At the other end, Quinton Gates answers the challenge with a jumper over Smith. On the shot, not good. Rebound owned by Hardaway.
That was a
lead
shot
pass.
Force.
Midcourt to Jackson. Continue.
First shot that Michael Smith really forced the entire afternoon. That was not a good shot. He knew it when he let it go.
We are now 3:46 on the scoreboard clock above the Marriott Floor Center. Or the Marriott Center floor. I'm getting excited. How's that for an alley-oop? Beautiful play with Sandle on the tag end of the course. 12 points.
A lot of people around the WAC are rooting for UTEP. That doesn't happen often. Trying to bring BYU back to the pack. They are the leader.
BYU with the ball. Ryan Taylor running at one guard spot. Marty Haas at the other. Gaefner's not in there. They go inside to Smith. Smith under heavy pressure. Drops it in for his 22nd point.
Well, that was a shot under
Richmond. Baseline right side. No shot available. Hardaway to bring it outside once again. We're at 17 on the shot clock. 2:38 on the time clock. Lob pass beautifully executed. Play underneath to Jeep Jackson. And he scores two more points in the ball game. And they're looking for him. Penetration of the lane. Block shot into the hands of Jackson. Breakaway. Going all the way. Hawes fouls him. Down they convert. This young man played a very smart game this afternoon, both ends of the court. His real name, of course, is Vernell. Even his mother doesn't call him that. Hits two free shots. He has 16. And it is 76-70. And right now, BYU needs a basket. Inside, Chapman, soft one-hander from the baseline. Not good. Taps back out. Taken by Jeep Jackson, who seems to be everywhere.
Now you're almost in a situation for Liddell Anderson. You got to foul. They don't shoot free throws well. You got to foul. That's what he's calling for right now. Just go ahead and foul him. Get the one-on-one situation. And that's even better than this.
Offensive foul. And a technical. Offensive foul, but then the technical. And if it's on Haskins, that is a big technical.
Well, a minute 33 to go. They got a six-point lead. Liddell Anderson was calling his players, trying to get their attention to create a foul.
Two-point game. I love it. 1:10 to go. The kind of a game we anticipated and hoped we would get. Whistle, foul. And they're not going to let him forget it or let him take it easy. He missed it. And the crowd goes ecstatic. And BYU has the ball. 56 seconds to go. And BYU can tie it up should they score on this trip. Smith.
Great move by Smith.
And now I'm sure you'll see the Bears take a timeout.
They've got to take the clock inside eight.
17 seconds remain on the scoreboard clock. The shot clock is dormant. Inbounds, way outside. And we got a steal and we got BYU with the ball. Brian Taylor with a hook, it's not good. We got a whistle and a foul, and BYU will be on the free throw line. 11 seconds to go in the ball game.
Well, a critical mistake right there by UTEP.
Taylor set again. He has hit six in a row. And BYU has a two-point lead with 11 seconds to go in the ball game. And once again, the Cougars take timeout with 11 seconds to go in the ball game. And now UTEP has the ball. BYU has put call in for defensive purposes. Ryan Taylor is in there. Chapman is in there. And we are with Blocker right now. And we have 8 seconds to go. Blocker all the way. Blocker scores. And we are tied with 3 seconds to go.
They love the Baron El Paso.
The most visible person, I think, in El Paso as far as recognition is concerned. Everywhere he's been there for 25 years, 26 years, and has posted such an outstanding record. And always seems to have a contender, no matter how many guys graduate.
Well, when you do a good job recruiting, and he certainly has, you get athletes like these, your job is much, much easier.
Norm Ellenberger, by the way, attired in that natty suit again today with shirt and tie.
Now for UTEP, you want to make sure you do not foul. Don't give them a chance to shoot free throws to beat you.
3 seconds to go. They go to Kapner. Let's go with a 40-footer. Ooh. It hits the rim at the buzzer. I mean, that baby was close.
I tell you, well-designed play by Liddell Anderson. Got the shot he wanted with only 3 seconds to go.